Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to make a pink lemonade cake. It's an eggless lemon based cake and it's a beautiful recipe for any time of the year. And look at those crumbs, it's beautiful. So let's get started. Into a bowl, take some sugar, into which we will add some lemon zest, and we will use a fork to mix them together till the sugar becomes fragrant. You can also use your fingers and rub it in between the fingers and keep it aside. And here I have some all-purpose flour, cornstarch, which makes the sponge spongy and light, sugar, baking soda, baking powder, and some salt to balance all the sweetness in the tart. Let's whisk it well and then sift it all together into a medium-sized bowl. If you're new to my channel and like my recipes, please consider subscribing to my channel. I'm gonna come up with amazing recipes here. Let us take some oil into a measuring jar. And now we will add some curd. I prefer using thick curd in this recipe and I would recommend the same to you. 3 tablespoons of lemon juice, which is gonna give you that lemony flavor to the cake, and the lemon zest and sugar mixture that we prepared earlier. Let's give it a good mix with a fork and then let us switch to a whisk and whisk it really well to emulsify the mixture. I also have an amazing eggless whole wheat chocolate cake recipe. I'm gonna add the link above here. Please check it. Let us add some vanilla extract to this liquid mixture and give it a quick mix and keep this aside. Let us take our dry ingredients and make a well in the center with the help of a spatula. Add in all the wet ingredients that we emulsified before. Fold in the wet ingredients into the dry ingredients following the cut and fold method. Cut and fold method is preferred here because it's gonna help us not to overmix the batter and also keeps our sponges soft and moist. Continue doing this till we find no dry air pockets of flour. Here I feel the consistency of my batter is really thick. I'm gonna add a tablespoon or two of the milk to adjust the consistency. I feel the batter is still a little thick, so I'm gonna add one more tablespoon of the milk. Totally I've added 2 tablespoons of milk here. The batter will look fizzy, don't worry, that is because of the reaction between the baking soda, salt and the lemon. That is perfectly alright. So our batter is ready, let's transfer it into 2 6-inch pans. To make sure I'm equally distributing the batter here, I'm using a kitchen scale to measure the weight of the batter. I will also add the link to the French Opera cake here, which is also eggless. Please do check the recipe. Let us tap the pans to knock off the air bubbles. These will go into the oven preheated at 160 degrees for about 28 to 32 minutes. I also baked these lemon slices, which I'll use in decorating the cake. Let us make some strawberry compote, which we will put in between 2 layers. Here I have some strawberries. I'm gonna add some lemon juice and cook this mixture for about 8 minutes till strawberries turn mushy. My strawberries were very sweet, so I didn't add any sugar. If your strawberries are not so sweet or sour they are, you can consider adding some sugar. Let us cool this mixture for a while. Here our sponges are done. I did the toothpick test and it came out clean. I'm demolding my cakes after about 10 minutes. And then I'm gonna cool them on the wire rack till they come to the room temperature, or you can just pop it into the fridge for a while. Peel off the parchment paper and let the cakes cool down completely. Let's prep up our buttercream. Since I'm making a pink lemonade cake, I thought I will make pink and yellow colored buttercream. Here I already have a yellow colored buttercream and some more buttercream I have in a bowl. I'm coloring it pink. Very soon I'm also coming up with varieties of buttercream recipes. I'm gonna add the link above here. Please check for the recipe there. The buttercream I'm using today is a not very sweet and not gritty silky smooth buttercream and it tastes amazing. Please check the link above here for the recipe. Let us start assembling our cake. Here I have placed a 6-inch cake circle on my turntable. I'm gonna add a dab of buttercream onto the cake circle and I'll place my first sponge. Since we have a filling for this cake, let us make a dam around the cake sponge so that our filling won't pop out or ooze out of the cake and it helps us decorate better. I'm adding all the strawberry compote we made. I'm gonna spread this and then I'm gonna put another layer of cake on top of this, just like so. And I'm not using any soaking syrup for this cake because it's a super moist sponge already. Now let us crumb coat the cake. Crumb coating means we are just gonna add a little bit of buttercream all around the sponges and we're gonna smear it or spread it using our spatula. And we are going to pop this into our fridge for about 30 minutes, at least 30 minutes, so that the buttercream holds all the crumbs. And when we do the final frosting, the crumbs won't come in contact with our buttercream. And this gives us a clean finish. I also have a beautiful recipe of baked New York style eggless cheesecake. I'm gonna add the link above here. Please check it. It's an amazing recipe. I'm adding more frosting on top of the cake and I'm gonna use my spatula to spread the frosting gently. And whatever extra, it's gonna fall down onto the sides. And I'm gonna use the same to spread it around the cake and I'm gonna make a thin layer. You can see that it is not perfect. That's what we're looking for. Let's just make a crumb coat just like so and let's pop this into the fridge for at least 30 minutes. Since I don't have a lot of time today because it's already evening and the lighting won't be great, so I did not get a chance to cool it for 30 minutes. I did only for 10 minutes and I'm going ahead and adding another final layer of the frosting here. You can see that I'm adding the buttercream all around the cake and with the help of my bent scraper, I'm gonna scrape the excess to make the outer surface look clean. Once you're happy with the finishing, chill the cake for about 30 minutes. Since the fault line cakes are in trend, I thought I'll show you how to make in this tutorial. I'm adding some pink buttercream at the bottom of the cake. I'm using my piping bag to add it and start scraping it gently. If you feel that there are any spots left, you can add more of the buttercream and start scraping it. Continue doing it till you're happy with the finish. If you like this recipe, please hit the like button. Also hit the bell button to get notifications when I post the new videos. Once we are happy with the finish, let's chill the cake for about 30 minutes again. Here I have a mixture of luster dust and vodka. Today I'm using gold color. I'm going to paint the edge of the pink fault line with the paint brush. If we chill the cake, this is easy to do. Otherwise, the buttercream will get stuck to our brush. This kind of decoration takes our cake to a whole different level and makes it look classy and beautiful. Here, I'm gonna smoothen the top of our cake. Now the cake is chilled. See how easy it is to smoothen the top. For the top, I mixed both yellow and pink buttercream, so the color looks a little different. I'm adding a blob of buttercream onto which I will add the sliced lemons that we baked before. Now I am painting those slices with the gold luster dust and vodka, the same mixture that we used to color our fault line. This gives that, you know, royal look to the cake, and the lemon slices, they have that natural texture onto which when we add the gold color, they really look beautiful and grand. This is how our cake looked after the final finish. Hope you like how I've decorated this cake. I'm gonna transfer the cake onto the cake stand and let's cut this pillowy soft cake. Look at this, how easy it is to cut this cake. It is a beautiful cake, you guys. You must try this recipe and you will love it for sure. Now let us take this slice and see how it looks from inside. Look at this. This is so beautiful. Look at those layers in the sandwich. Let us taste it. Look at those beautiful crumbs. I'm really loving this aroma of the lemonade here. Thank you for watching, guys. Please stay connected and stay tuned for more such amazing recipes. You guys take care. Bye-bye.